Hello friends, this is Neeraj Kumar. I welcome you on behalf of KSG. Today we will discuss the idea of bad banks. Now, India's banks have been facing the problem of stressed asset for quite some time. And with the coronavirus-induced economic crisis, banks fear that their asset quality will deteriorate. In view of this, a discussion has started on the idea of bringing bad banks into play again in order to help the Indian banking system tide over this crisis. For our sake of knowledge, in the bank, non-performing assets are more than 7.3 lakh crore currently. NPAs, as they are popularly called, or non-performing assets, are assets or loans of banks or financial institutions where the lenders have not been able to pay the interest or capital for more than 90 days. This has been a problem for a while, and the first organized attempt was passing of the Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Assets and Enforcement of Security Interests, popularly known as SARFAESI Act 2002. Asset reconstruction companies were formed based on this act to buy out the NPAs or the non-performing assets from the banks and recover as much as possible, recover value from out of them. They've enjoyed some success in the last 18 odd years. But due to multiple legal and operational challenges, they have not been as successful as they were expected to be. Now, the genesis of the current discussion and enthusiasm lies in the asset quality review, the famous asset quality review conducted by the RBI in 2015. And later, the 2017 economic survey examined this idea. It suggested that the country should look at the creation of a public sector asset rehabilitation agency, PARA. In 2018, the creation of a separate bad bank entity was also proposed by the Saksha committee. How does this bad bank work? It is expected that once the bad banks, the bank's bad loans are transferred to the newly created entity, the so-called bad bank, the banks would again become agile and fuel economic growth with fresh credit. Now, bad banks may not be able to rescue Indian banks from their NPAs altogether, but they can surely provide some respite in these bad times. Now, what is a bad bank? What is the definition of a bad bank? The bad bank is called so because it houses bad loans, or it takes over the bad loans or non-performing assets. The non-performing assets technically can remain in the bank's book forever, but they hurt the bank's business and ultimately its viability. Investors or all the concerned parties see large NPAs as a sign of the bank's ill health or financial weakness. And over a period of time, the higher the NPAs, the lower is the bank's ability to borrow, lend, or conduct business in general. The NPAs can be taken out of bank's books and transferred to a bad bank. Bad bank aids in the recovery of these risky assets. As a result, a bank will be able to clean up its balance sheet and reduce its exposure to all the risky assets. Therefore, a bad bank is expected to help the banks by absorbing all their bad assets, typically at a price below the book value of these loans, and manage them. A fairly old instrument in the global financial market. The first was in 1980, a US-based bank created a bad bank in 1988 to hive off its toxic assets. The bad bank did its job. It was not supposed to take any deposit from public or offer any loan, but simply recovered all the bad debts and tried to recover as much money as it could. Finally, the bad bank was liquidated as it had served this purpose. Many countries, including Sweden, Indonesia, and Ireland, have these bad banks. However, these face several challenges. Transactions with bad banks often lack transparency. And as the valuations raise questions, they are always considered to be too low or too high. In India's case, transfer will be from a public sector bank to another public sector entity, and the government will end up paying for both. In the last 2 years, the government has provided more than 2 lakh crores into state-run banks and faced a lot of criticism. The question will be, where will the money for bad bank come from? In addition, a bank does not have any special tools to speed up recovery of bad loans. They surely are expert, but we also have almost 27 asset reconstruction companies, and the experience of them with them has been mixed. The question is, would the bad bank be able to pay for NPAs more than the existing ARCs offer? We'll have to see. We must remember that bad banks reduce the burden on banks and increase their profitability by helping them reduce margins for bad loans and allow them to focus on lending. But it doesn't make the NPAs go away altogether. In this case, whatever has been proposed as losses will have to be shared between investors and taxpayers. The end game is the recovery of money, and it is one of the tools. If it's not supported well by legislation and the courts, it will not achieve its aim. Thank you.